All right, the rims are done. Took a heck of a lot longer than I thought it would, and a lot more work. But here it is, and here's how I did it. All right, I'm gonna have to call these done. I thought the color was gonna be a little bit closer, but this one's got a little bit more red in it. It's really hard to get the color to match because I wasn't quite sure how much of the rim was faded. But you can see that this is a slightly darker color, but I'm okay with that. My fabulous masking job looks pretty good. So new wheel bearings put in the front and the rear. Pretty happy with that. The rear ones were shot. The spacers were put in backwards on both of these. The front and the rear. So anyway, that's fixed. I've got all new bearings, all new seals, fresh coat of paint. There's no clear on this, on the outer rim, and there's no clear on the inside where the bead is. So the clear pretty much stops with the gold, and that's got a pretty good line on it. I use that fine blue masking tape, and it seemed to work pretty good.
Well, since I screwed up the recording on this video, I'm just going to sort of voice over part of it here and just sort of carry on. That's enough of this. I'll show you now exactly what I did, and I'll just start with a little bit of the wheel bearing removal and replacement.
The bearings removed, the left and the right. This is the left side of the wheel. Paint's pretty faded. The aluminum rims are, these ones aren't in bad shape, but there's quite a bit of corrosion along the inside, and gonna get that all cleaned up in this one. Okay, so the wheels, this is front wheel, left side, this is where the speedo assembly sort of sits in here. The bearings have been pulled out. Those bearings look original. They're a little crunchy. That's the spacer that goes in between them. I did take it out last night, because I was impatient and didn't video it, but it's pretty straightforward. There's a little seal that goes over top. You pop that off with a screwdriver, and then the spacer, you just sort of pull it off to one side and use your like a drift or a punch, whatever you want to call it, and basically punch the bearing out, and then the spacer comes out, and then you flip it over and do the other side. So that's done. Got the bearings out, and they definitely need replacement. All right, here's the back wheel, and pretty much same deal as the front. Not bad as far as the condition goes. There's a bit of corrosion there, and it's very difficult to get off and make look proper again. So I think what I might do is just see if I can just take these wheels down to the wheel place and just maybe get them to machine that surface, and then I'll do the rest of the work. All right, well, you guys saw how much of a challenge that was. The front ones came out a little bit easier, but same procedure. Even after, you know, making sure I had a nice edge on the drift, it was still a little bit of a challenge to find the lip of the inner race. What's happening here is when you're tapping on these things, you're actually trying to find the edge of the inner race right there, and you're going to tap on that. So what you're doing is getting down the center of the spacer and moving it off to one side so you can get a little bit of an edge. Okay, that's all of the parts bagged up, keeping the bearings for now, and just labeled everything. The back wheel's cleaned up as much as I'm going to clean it up and disassembled. I don't know, I may end up taking a wheel and getting that gunk and some of that corrosion off. This is not easy work. You can see the corrosion. It's sort of a mix of corrosion, old rubber, and whatever, just gunk. And it's turning out pretty good. Of course, the outsides were machined, and I'm going to be cleaning that. But the inside is what I'm working on now. And it seems like the best tool, although it's a lot of elbow grease, is just a sponge pad. It is the best thing. It gets in all the little nooks and crannies. It doesn't do any damage to the aluminum, but it gets all the gunk out, and it's working pretty good. Because here's where I haven't gone yet, and that's just some leftover residue from the tires and some corrosion. Anyway, it seems to be working pretty good. I'll just carry on with that. I gotta say the all balls bearing kits are really good. Not only do they supply you with the new bearings, obviously, but the cool thing about this kit, and I'm not sure about any other kits, but this one here also includes all of the bearing seals and the wheel seals and some of the other seals, like the speedo unit requires a seal. Pops in there like that, and this one is completely all gunged up. It's all dried up, and of course on the other side, this was the old one, and that's on the right side. The left side one was so badly damaged that I just threw it in the garbage, because the kit comes with the two outer seals, and then depending on which model you have, you're going to need one of these seals. One, two, or three. It is going to fit the speedo. So it's kind of like a universal kit. You're not going to use all the seals, but just find the right size one. Use a micrometer if you have to. And just going to pop the seal in before I put this all back together. Cool. Nice kit. All right, so on the left side is the little speedo connector. And all I did was just pull the seal out, because the new seal comes with the wheel bearing kit, which is kind of cool. And there's a little snap ring, and I don't know if you can see it right there. Yeah, a little snap ring. And all I did was I just took that snap ring off and pulled all these bits out, and pulled all the old grease, and then re-greased it with a waterproof grease, and put it all back together again. I also noticed that the coupler that fits in the little slot with the wheel. Okay, so that coupler fits in that in those two slots, and I just noticed that the coupler was bent. So I have a feeling somebody probably manhandled this as well. And so all I did was I just pulled it all out, straightened all the parts, re-greased everything, put the new seal in, and then wiped it up. I'm going to take this to the paint shop. It's about on the bottom. Is about the only place on the whole bike where there wasn't sun fade, and I'm going to see if they can match up that color, so that I can repaint this, but it's primarily for the rims. And that's that. So I'm gonna bag this, tag it, it's all overhauled and ready for reassembly. Well, it looks like it's coming down to about 2 weeks worth of work. The disc looks pretty good. There used to be gold paint there. I don't know how it came off or why. But anyway, in this light, the rims actually look pretty good, but they're faded and they actually look pretty crappy. So I got some paint, gonna paint them tomorrow, and should look nice. So I bought this used rack, this little clothes rack. It's collapsible and has wheels, and it'll hold up to 250 pounds. So perfect for painting stuff. Charging my light, gonna get my compressor all ready, get my paint gun, get my paint all ready, and we'll be doing a base gold. And then one coat of clear will go on after there's plenty of gold on there, and that should do the trick. All right, so after all the tape is removed and they've had a couple of days to cure, they look pretty good. Like I said, they're a little bit darker than what they were before, but I think I kind of like this look. Of course, the corrosion's all under control. That looks great. Nice fine edge with the masking, and ready for tires. All I gotta do now is the tire valves installed. I got some new ones coming in. They're just on order. Just waiting for those. I'll call that done for this, for the wheels. And I'll slide in the swing arm and a couple other pieces that I painted today too. Okay, I'm just going to throw this on the end of the wheel video. This is the swing arm. And that is a little outer ring that goes on the back of the wheel, the rear wheel. And of course there's basically the drive shaft, the drive gear. And this thing turned out incredibly nice. Really happy with the way that turned out, the color. So much better than all that rust and corrosion that was on it before. So they're out here baking in the sun. I'll call this done, I guess, for now. The wheels are done. And these parts, I guess the next thing is to get the frame rolling. So that's it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. I know it was kind of off, but I was at work for a while and there's quite a bit of gaps in between. I'm just trying to keep the whole thing rolling into one, but I'm gonna have a rolling chassis here pretty soon. Stay tuned.